I'm up here today. What's going on? So if you guys don't know me, I'm Lucidy, or Luci for short, and Landmark, I've been streaming recently. It's down for a hotfix today, during the time when I usually stream. And I wanted to get another stream out there this week because I haven't streamed that much and it's been kind of like sporadic. So we're gonna be doing some Sims 4 house building instead. So I moved my my camera up here so that you guys can see my building tools because they end up down below. And I don't want my face to be covering up the game part of the gaming stream because that seems counterproductive. So we're going to be playing The Sims 4 today. If you can see on the other side of the screen, which is that way, I have an inspiration picture that I'm going to be trying to recreate in the Sims 4, or, you know, close to it. We're going to do close. And sometimes our inspiration turns out to just be, you know, a suggestion rather than a guideline, and because we can't actually do the things that we want to do in The Sims 4, because sometimes, like, the angle, like, trying to make an angled balcony or a roof at a 45 degree angle is a little bit beyond my skill level at the moment. I'm sure that there's some awesome sim building gurus out there who know how to do it, but I unfortunately do not. So I just tend to, like, change things around when I hit a roadblock and do something different. So this is kind of the picture that I'm looking to try to recreate. It's, I mean, I wouldn't call it a cottage, but it is pretty rustic and looks more like a farmhouse, but like an upscale sort of farmhouse, like a farmhouse that's been redone to be a bed and breakfast. So that's what we're gonna try to do. And I've got my lot that I picked out might be a little bit too small, so we'll see. If the game noise ends up being a little, like, too loud or too soft, just let me know in chat. I am watching chat, it's over here. So yeah, just let me know if the volume needs to be adjusted any. And I'll try to do that. So, alright. So the lot that I picked, I think, is like 30 by 20. I tend to build on the smaller scale rather than pick the biggest lots available to me in The Sims. But we'll see if we can do what we want to do in the space available to us. We may not be able to. So let's try. I am going to turn down my volume a little bit because it's basically just background music while you play. So just let me know if it is a little overwhelming or louder than my mic and makes it hard for you guys to hear me. So, all right, let's try to build this, like, farmhouse slash bed and breakfast thing. And now that I've moved my camera up here, you guys can see what's going on down here. So I thought that would be less distracting than it was previously, because I had my camera where I normally have it for, like, MMOs and things like that, and it covers up the chat window that can be distracting. But we don't have a chat window, and we actually have build tools down here, so. And I did something silly, and I stupidly don't have the inspiration pick up for myself. Well done. Well done. So I'm gonna grab it really quick. Thank the technology gods for Chrome, because everything that I save as a bookmark gets changed over, and I can access it on any of my devices, and that makes me very happy. I think it's this one. Yay! I have my house picture now. That was easy. Make it bigger so I can see it. All right. Find room on my desk to put it, because there's really not that much room on my desk. You can't see all the clutter. Thankfully, it's down here. So you just see less clutter. I mean, there's still some stuff going on behind me and things like that. But, okay, so now I have my inspiration pick. You guys can see the inspiration pick that I'm looking at. Hey, Kerman, what's up? And guys, don't be shy. Don't be shy. I like interacting with people who are in chat. So say hi, give me a wave, talk about things, tell me how you're doing in the spring challenge if you guys are doing that. I am also trying to complete the spring challenge. I'm almost there. So I don't want that room. So this is the area we have to work with, and I think it's going to be too small. So I'm going to go back to my world. I tend to build in Newcrest because it's just this big empty area. So, oh, this might actually be better. Do we want to go even bigger? Let's check this. Let's check this one out. I'm looking forward to trying to work on that path with all of the flowers and plants around it. I think that'll be really fun to do. Oh yeah, this looks much better. This looks good. That's quite a bit of build space there. So, first thing I'm gonna start doing is I think I'm gonna build this way. So the house is here, and then a little path comes to the house. So I think that's the way we're going to build today. And if you guys haven't built in The Sims before, it's actually really fast and really easy compared to other iterations of The Sims that you could build in. Hey, Oak Moon! This new landmark skin looks so much like The Sims, it's crazy. Yeah, well The Sims is The Sims. The landmark's down for its hotfix, and it, oddly enough, happened like exactly when I usually start streaming, and I didn't want to stream at like 8 o'clock in the morning, for obvious reasons. So I decided to do a little bit of house building in The Sims today. Hopefully you guys still enjoy it. I know that most of my audience does landmark, and that's cool. I do like finding out creative outlets wherever I can in games. So The Sims is gonna have to be it today. I just lost my inspiration picture because my phone went to sleep. There it is. So I'm changing the shape of the house a little bit. I just want to give it a little bit more. Just a little bit more character than just a box. And the great thing about The Sims now is that you can push and pull on all of the walls and basically all of the features to create the kind of look that you're going for without having to move, like redo everything every time you change something. And as you can see, I'm actually moving. I'm actually moving the whole lot around as I go as well. I just want to get a good shape. I think that's going to be a fun shape. And I'm trying to get it placed on the lot so I have, like, I'm not cutting myself off for building space on the back or on either of the sides, but I still have plenty of space in the front to get that tree and that path and the little wishing well and things like that. Hey, Ashlyn! Hi, Oakmoon. Oakmoon. How are you guys doing? And as easy as Google SketchUp. I've never used Google SketchUp. I will say that unless I have, like, in-game tools in order to, like, design things, I'm actually really awful at it. I don't feel like I'm that artistic at all. The Sims and actually Landmark make it really easy for me to be creative while not having to do 100% of everything myself. So I actually like Sword Coast Legends for that too. Yeah, I'm basically just chilling too, Ashlyn. We're landmarks down for the patch. I decided to do some Sims 4 house building instead. So let's you can kind of see my inspiration pick up there. That's kind of what I'm working on doing. I'm gonna change it a little bit, I think. So it looks like this just has the two levels. I think it does. I'm trying to look at the doorway, and I think it only has two levels because that doorway looks pretty tall compared to the house. So let's see what it looks like when we put a roof on. And they've made roofing even easier than it was. Much easier, because it didn't used to be that simple to get a nice looking roof. And now I feel like they've made a lot of improvements, especially in this area. As you can see, I just push and pull on the roof and I get the shape that I want. And it's really easy to combine the roofs. I just make this one a little bit shorter and it's now seamless. It just seamlessly goes right into this roof and looks so smooth. I can even get rid of these eaves here if I don't want it to come through. So it's just really easy to build. Really, really easy to build in this game. Sure if I want to get rid of them. Maybe. It does look a little awkward. Let's get rid of that. So really easy to put in roofs and all kinds of things. And all of these points are points that you can push or pull or manipulate in some way to change the way the roof looks. So I can bow these out a little bit if I want to. That actually looks kind of cute, and I might keep it. It definitely looks like a barn turned B&E, like I was talking about earlier, that my inspiration picture kind of looks like. Because it definitely looks it doesn't look like a cottage. It's way too big to be a cottage, but it looks nice and well kept. So I was thinking that it was like a cottage turned B&E. B&E, not B&E. That's a crime. B&B. I'd actually like that darker color. So already deviating from my inspiration picture, which I do a lot, but again, I'm not trying to recreate it exactly. I'm just sort of like trying to do little touches. Definitely want to get some of these, get some of these chimneys in, because it looks like it has those. Trying to decide what colors and what sort of shape we want. It looks like it's made out of stone in the picture, so, or some sort of like light colored brick. So I'm trying to recreate that. I think we're gonna have to go with this. I kinda wish that I could get them bigger, but I can't. I'm a very indecisive builder. You guys will quickly realize that. I'll put something down, see how it looks, be like, nah, I don't like the way that looks. Change it, rearrange it. Hmm. And part of the reason why I picked, this picture caught my attention is because the Get Together stuff pack gave us Windenburg, which has all of these like old world kind of styled houses, and it matches the textures that I have, that I got from that picture pack really well. I'm just trying to find where they put it. So these are the Get Together textures that we got, and I absolutely love them. I think that they're just really cool. And I like mixing and matching them. So, for example, on the corners here, it looks like they have sort of diagonal pieces. So I'm just looking to see what kind of pieces I want to include here. I think I want to do these ones. And you can match them to the colors. Really easy to match them to the colors. Them meeting in the middle, and I did not do that correctly. Now I have them meeting at the bottom. Yeah, we want them meeting at the top. So we're gonna switch them. There we go. That looks better. Yeah, that is part of the reason why I wanted that stuff pack in particular. I really, really liked the way that it totally looks old world country sort of thing. I'm rethinking my roofs now. Don't mind me. I do this a lot. Oops. Yeah, I felt the same way. It did, my game time definitely got swallowed by Landmark when, the new update came out. Before the update came out, I actually bought all of the, the stuff packs and the expansion packs and everything that went with this game. So if there's anything specific that you want to see, I can probably show it off for you. Just really, really like these patterns here. Love these patterns. Let's try. Oops. Nope, still messed up. That feels a bit too. I wish I could have it, excuse me, I wish I could have it, so it would fill in the area between, like, the ones I just put down, rather than trying to fill the entire area. Like, if I could put two things there and then have it fill there, but it doesn't want to do that, so we're stuck clicking. Is this an expansion? Yeah, well, the colors, the palette that I'm using right now is, yes. So these little icons on the top of the designs show you which expansion or stuff pack they're from. And if they don't have an icon, it's from the base game. So where this has that little purple icon with the people in it, it's from the Get Together stuff pack or expansion pack. I'm not sure which one it is. But some of the things that I'm going to use are from the base game as well. to use this texture, and I'm wondering if I can do that on the bottom and have it look good still. I kind of like having that stone at the bottom. We could add that to the top to give it a little bit of a little pop. Oops, that's the wrong color. Could do that. Could always break it up with some windows, too. I didn't even finish doing this back of the house. I wish they had a texture where I had the stone on the bottom and the angled piece as well. I could do this. But it looks a little awkward. Being all stone. What if I do all stone? Okay. I'm very much a let's try this out sort of builder. Let's try this out sort of builder. I have a very hard time visualizing things in my mind, so I find just putting it down and seeing if I like it works better for me. I like the first one you did for the top. Also, welcome, little pink dino. You like this one? The one on the roof here? That's a fun pattern there. I'm also wondering if I want to do this on the bottom. No, I think it's too white if I do it that way. Like there's just way too much white, not enough color for different textures. Let's see what happens when we put some doorways on and some windows. That might brighten it up a little bit more too. I'm trying to find a good doorway for this. This might work. If I can get the right color. Doesn't want to be the right color brown, though. I kind of want a double door. But I also kind of want a double door that has glass in it. Make it a little bit taller. Maybe that'll work. Because now when we make it taller, we can add these doors. Oh, I don't think this is going to be the right color brown. That's too bad. It's too bad. Alright, we'll shrink them back down again. The one with the cross patterns, the one that you said was too white, it'd break up the space more on the top, in my opinion. Alright, we can check that out. Let's see. Was it... not sure. I don't remember which one it was anymore. I think it was one of these. I just don't want the top to feel too heavy. I also want to break it up quite a bit with windows. That could work. Add a little bit of visual appeal without being too busy. I just don't want it to take away from the cross patterns on the sides, because I want those to be a visual interest. Actually, I think I'm going to do those over here, too. I think on the inside corner it'll look good, too. Oh, and I forgot to do the side. Oops. I don't like that I can't just... It won't just fill in the leftover space. Second one from the right. This one. I probably moved my not sure if you were talking about the one with stone. Or this one. Oh, I see. It's almost exactly the same, it just has another beam. And I like the pattern on the top being a little bit different. Let's see what we can do with some doors and some windows, though. Because I feel like windows are going to break it up quite a bit once we start adding them. Especially if I make them not so heavy looking, if they're just clean and maybe white. Shuttered doors, shuttered windows. Definitely looks rustic. But do we have them for each side? No. Just on the one side. Really? That's it? That's unfortunate. Yeah, with the 30-second delay and me moving all around and everything else, it's a little bit difficult. Not sure. I'm not sure about windows. Try to make them even. Doesn't always happen though. And you can't always make them perfectly at all the windows. Like, I don't think I can evenly put them here. That's alright. Maybe we can find a really cool rustic looking door too. I think this is the matching one. I really wish that this was slightly bigger so it would fit in this space here. That's alright. sure if I like it white, but we'll see. Maybe we can switch. I'm all over the place. That's alright. This is legitimately how I build all the time. Because I just start putting things down and seeing what I like and what I don't like. And then changing it. And then redoing everything else. And then at the bottom, we'd have to do this, actually. That would have been a smarter thing to do. And then change these. I've deviated quite far from my inspiration picture already. Yeah. I wonder how the top is gonna look now. Can you do white on white? No, you can't. Oh well, maybe you can. May not be as visually interesting. Oh, that's really white. How did I get that one? Or is it just lighting? Oh, I'm opposite. Because we want this to be match the white there. Yeah, that doesn't look like our inspiration at all. Not even remotely. I think the white windows is what's making it look better with the white. Maybe I should have picked darker windows. I love how easy it is to change things. Even like a lot of things. I really love how easy it is to just change things and rearrange things and redecorate and change your color palette that you're working with. It's one of my favorite things about The Sims 4. I remember in The Sims 3, I think it was, that you could choose like themes, and you could apply it to like everything in your house. So that was fun, but I think it was also, is that the one we picked before? I think so. I thought it was going to be too much with the darker windows, but I think I like it. I should really do speed builds to speed up past all this stuff. Or experiment before I start streaming and figure out what colors and stuff I want to use and then just build. But that would take away some of the fun, I think. You guys don't get to watch me stumble around and change things 5 million times. Thank you. mouse trapped. Hate that. I went with a wireless mouse for a little while, but it kept quitting on me and like in the middle of playing a game, and that's the last basically place you want your mouse to quit on you, especially when you're playing an MMO. You like the door with the glass on it. That's from Get Together. Let's check it out. Ah, this one? Let's switch it and see how it looks. Because with the, oh, that does look nice. With the stone around it, it sort of ties into the Windenburg feel anyway. It's a little too dark. Aw, look how cute it is. Yeah. That's cute. I like it. And I may go through and, like, delete some of these windows and keep it a little bit more streamlined. Because it's hard to put in, like, separate walls sometimes when you have too many windows. But we'll see. We can switch that around later. Let's put in some more windows. Hopefully I'm putting them on the right levels. I don't think I am. I think that one's a little bit too low. Actually, the easiest way to tell is to go in and make sure they all match up here, which I think they do. Yeah. That's the easiest way for me to tell if my windows are off. To go inside the build. Try to make things even. I like symmetrical things. Especially when I'm building houses. Nope, that's not even remotely. Better. There we go. Tons of windows. Maybe too many windows. We'll see. Yeah, I think it's too many windows. Get rid of these windows. I wish I could put one in the middle, but there's no good middle here because these are double windows. Maybe if we move the door a little, give some light fixtures, it'll be better. We can also put some plants here. Sitting on my foot and it's gone to sleep. I really should learn not to do that, but I still haven't. Still not a way to put one in the window. Oh well. Whoops. That's not what I meant to do. I don't want there to be too many windows so that I can't break up the rooms. The inside and put a lot of rooms in. My foot is totally asleep. I should not have been sitting on it. But I did anyway, because I'm silly. Alright, so looking a little bit like our inspiration picture. there. So got a couple fireplaces or chimneys for fireplaces. Got sort of the thatched roof look going on as much as we can anyway. Got the windows in, got the doors in, got sort of the overall look close. I'm gonna work on, I think, landscaping now. So let's add in a really cute path. Yeah, I was thinking that too. Like I should definitely put some different windows down on the bottom and then have the smaller windows for the top. Definitely a good idea. I was thinking about that. So maybe we can actually leave these windows for the bottom and do something like... Oh, those are bigger. Those are bigger. We could do something like this on the bottom. Might be a little bit too heavy. But we could put some of these like cute decorative windows in. Those would actually look pretty good as oh, what did I just pick? This. Those would actually look pretty good as decorative windows at the top, maybe? I don't know, I kind of like the shutter windows at the top. I really like these shutter windows. It's hard for me to get away from them now. Maybe we could actually put in stone windows at the bottom. Problem with that is that they're not going to match. I can play around with that in a few minutes, I think. Not feeling super inspired by any of these windows yet. This one actually might match. Those would match. See how we like those. I'm not sure where I'd want to put them though. I wish that they matched completely, like had the stone on the outside. Is that an option? Is this an option? So I like that. Might be fun. Put in a couple bay windows. Or like a lot of bay windows. I'm so sad that that's not even. I think we're gonna have to fix it. By pulling this in. Want to do one now, two. Now it should be even. Why is it not even? There's actually too much for the bottom right now. Let's fix this whole thing first. So I'd have to go one more in if I wanted them even. Now everything's nice and even. I don't know why it's that important to me, but it just is. That side's right. Aw, there we go. No, it's still not even. because this is a single door. I was thinking it was a double door. We'd have to move window over one. Yeah. I like this doorway. I'm just not sure about the windows. I like diversifying the windows, but I'm not sure if I see any that I really, really like. That's too white. I like these long ones, but I think I went too stylized and rustic with these ones. Maybe not. One thing I could do is actually, oh, there's the other one with the reverse shutter. But it's not the correct color. The right color brown. I don't think it is. Well, it might be. That could be fun. I do like the shutters. That's pretty cute. They work on the bottom too? Maybe. Yeah, I was thinking that too. The first and floor windows match for some reason. I was actually going to go back and, That's alright. I was actually thinking about getting rid of these ones and doing either... Nope, those won't fit up there. I always like these ones, but I don't think it's the right color, unfortunately. I can do white, but... The little windows up there. Completely different. Completely different. Randomly different windows. I could do these long windows. There's like attic windows. I like that. That's something decorative. Maybe the stained glass goes up here. Work. these windows that are all different sizes. I don't know. I know that I do like the shutters on the bottom, though. Not exactly even. I think it's because I'm a couple window lengths off. Or a couple sections off. Sorry. See, this, no matter how I do it, doesn't match up because this isn't a double door. But this should work better now. Yeah, that works better. That's unchanged. Alright. I'm also looking to see if I can put... decorative things up. Matches this color? That'd be kind of weird if we didn't. There's also some other cool things that I could put in, but we'd need a taller... I don't think that we can... That's too bad. Maybe we should just make this taller. So that we can add these things. Things up a little bit more, I think. But it's three. Of course it's three. Of course. Thankfully, it's super easy to change. A lot of the Windenburg windows and things you can't do on the smaller smaller walls. So it might be fun to add these